almost called legislative by the Lisbon Treaty. In fact, what we have is a legislative procedure, not exactly legislative institutions, but it's in the lines, let's say. We have written rules with very formal requirements, motivation, publication, we have binding acts, direct effect and direct application. We have a Supreme Court, uniform interpretation and application, and we have the widespread application guaranteed by national judges and authorities. So the rule of law is another essential feature of this supranational order. Now let's enter in the most problematic part of my presentation. There are a number of dilemmas about democracy, and these are two very, very, very Greek ones. At least I express them in very Greek words. The dilemma of demos, because as I told, there is still lacking a real European identity. And the treaty reinforced this lack, because even if there are many references to citizens and to citizenship, all the references to people is peoples with S, so the peoples of the member states. So there is a sort of choice of letting the demos at national level while building a politeia, so an organized legal body of citizens at European level. So whatever is about identity is more national, whatever is about law can be as well European. So it's more a construct of law than a construct of, you know, a sentiment, feeling, belonging, all these things creating really identity. So democracy, as being democracy, also demos, is not politeiacracy, it's democracy. We have this lack in identity, and this is a problematic element in the European construct. And so this is why maybe what we have more than a European democracy is a European republic. And this is interesting, because the word republic for many centuries has been considered a sort of synonymous of democracy. Then the two diverged in the last couple of centuries. And democracy is now something, or better, the adjective democratic is something we can apply to any level, from the little association to the big organizations like the European Union, while republic is remain, for some reason, strictly linked with the notion of sovereignty. But in fact, republic is a different focus from democracy. While democracy has a focus on the relation between people and authority, republic has a focus on public goods, res publica. And we have lots of references to public goods. Only from Article 3, we find all this list of public goods: freedom, security, and justice, environment, economic, social, and territorial cohesion, solidarity, scientific and technological advance, cultural heritage, price stability, and the list could go on and on. So we have a very much attention on public goods in the European treaties. So maybe we have more than a supranational democracy, we have maybe a supranational republic, but that's, strangely enough, is not in our understanding of this, the modern understanding of this word. And now let's move to, I think, the most interesting point and most concrete point of my presentation, which is about solidarity. I think solidarity is an important element in building a demos, because solidarity is about all these things. Solidarity is about support, safety, interdependence, trust, confidence. Is about building a community. It comes from the adjective solidus, which is solid, and it means substantial, stable, and it makes reference to the fact that we belong to something which has his own effectivity and as a community of support, a community of trust, a community of belonging. So I think that building solidarity in the European system would bring to building a demos in a certain sense, or at least could help in building a demos. Yet we have, and this is, sorry, this is all we have about solidarity. In the usual Article 3, we have taken every kind of things today from Article 3, and you see there are still things to take out of it. So we have a reference to the European economic model, competitive social market economy aiming at full employment and social progress. We have a reference to the combat to social exclusion and discrimination, and social justice and protection, equality, solidarity between generations. And we have a reference to the territorial cohesion and solidarity among member states. So solidarity is expressed in all the possible, from all the possible perspectives. Yet we have a strong lack, in my opinion, of solidarity in the Union, because we have this budget dilemma. We have, about financing solidarity, we have a huge quota of a tiny amount. The biggest quota of the European budget is about solidarity, because it's about regional policy, social policy, agriculture, and support in many different ways, research, in many, many, very different ways, people and territories. Yet this is a huge quota of a tiny budget, because the European budget is just 1% of the GDP of the Union. So this is, in fact, in relative terms, is a small budget. And of course, this means it's, in relative terms, is incredibly smaller than the national budget, which is usually over 40% of national GDP. And this means that we have much more solidarity, visible or less visible, but we have it at national level than we could even imagine to have at European level. And then there is another problem, and this is a problem about the own resources, and I put them into brackets because they are not so own. The own resources chart you see in this chart, which looks like a moon in a dark sky, has a very big gray slice. This gray slice is national transfers from the so-called GNI-based own resource. At the beginning, in the 70s, the own resources of the union, the community, were really own. So they mostly came from tax borders, tax custom duties, or agricultural duties, and so tax on borders. Now, as with globalization, this own resource declined, we had a rise in the national transfers, which were a residual own resource aimed only to complement and to fulfill the needs of the community when the other resources were not enough. But now this is, you see, almost more than 64%. So is really the biggest resource of the Union is not own, it's from member states. This means that the solidarity is not among citizens, it's among states, if ever, because states have to contribute to the European budget. And the good news is that this is going to be to change, because the next generation EU has this big orange side, which will be raised on the market through European bonds. And this will be finally own resources. Even better, these bonds will be repaid by creating new European own resources, European taxes. And so this will be real own resources. Why this is so important? Let me tell you that I think that in a supranational model, fiscal solidarity should be among citizens and not among countries.